Hello, I recently did a pen test on a Go application and I realized I didn't fully understand Go applications, so I will get practice by solving crackmes written in the Go language. This will allow me to get used to Go-related internals and patterns. The first crackme I will demonstrate is called goCrackme. Let's look at the comments for this crackme. Not bad, for whatever reason it seems like you can't solve it on Wine, blah blah blah. Still a beginner, but to me it looks like it is decrypting the code itself and unpacking it, do you know? And then we also see some hints. Username, user profile, base XX. I don't like it that the guy is giving hints, especially if the difficulty is rated 2. So I already downloaded it and placed it in the documents folder. H6D has always been my favorite hex editor. Let's search for password. We find one, and the first thing that we notice is that all strings are following each other without any break or markers. Let's run the crackme. I type in test, we get wrong. Let's type in the wrong. Let's search for wrong now in the hex file. We find it with exclamation mark. UTC, UTC, yeah. This seems to be a random order. And then some other debugging strings. Let's look for other wrongs now. Nope, nothing special. All error messages. It's time to open this in IDA. I will be using IDA Freeware. I always check load resources. Okay, import segment seems to be destroyed. Could not locate system script file golang.idc. Oh, hexrays, come on, are you kidding me? Do you really want me to use a Chinese version for this? Okay, let's try to solve this the legal way and let's create the script itself. Let's search for the IDC files. We indeed only find idc.idc and not golang.idc. So let's try to create this one. Control Z to terminate. Access denied because I need to do this at administrator. So let's copy paste the comment and do it again. The file has been created now. Let's close all these windows now. Okay, we open IDA again. Drag the file into it. Check load resources. Okay, runtime error, attempt to call undefined function main. Okay, it looks like we need to do a little bit more. So let's open administrator prompt and open the golang.idc. Void main. Wait, noop alert. This needs to be static main. This should be it. Repeating myself is boring. Load resources, okay. Could not find signature file go std. Hexrays, I'm angry at you. But at least that little hack I did seems to be working and analysis is going on. In the meantime, we can look at all these useful names. Hexrays, I'm less angry because this is kinda useful to me. In IDA, I'll always press the spacebar to get rid of this graph view. I don't like graphs. I don't really know yet what I'm looking for. So let's turn on the quick filter. Let's search for wrong. No. Maybe password. No. Yeah, let's look for string functions then and see what we can hook. Okay. Runtime CMP string. This looks like a useful function. I press X to check the cross references. Let's see. They are all internal ones, so this seems to be Go internal stuff, nothing interesting for us. Let's just put a breakpoint here and see what happens. Something else we can look into and set a breakpoint on. No. No, so let's just run it. Yes, 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 I trust my own computer. Password, nothing gets triggered, no breakpoint. Okay, this is not that interesting then. Let's use a quick filter again and look for other stuff. CMP, CMP body, and CMP. Okay, CMP body is more internal. Let's set a breakpoint there. What else can we look for? The guy did give a base int, so let's search for that. Okay, we find an init. Let's look at this base64 init. Cross references, there is only one, it seems, at the end, and that goes to the top again. Okay, slowly scrolling up, I see some strings related to base64. Let's just set a breakpoint here and let's run this again. This time a breakpoint is triggered. Let me close all the windows which we don't need. Modules, threads, on the graph view, let's get rid of that. Hex view we can keep, and stack view we will keep too. This should be good enough. Now I don't really know yet what I'm looking for, so I think I will just single step in this application and look at the register and see what they contain. This is probably a data structure related to Go. Something else. I think we can all ignore this anyways. Okay, let's keep stepping. Here we see the alphabet. Let's step over this one. Continue, step over it again. This is that alphabet. Let's look into the memory to see if we see something interesting. So we follow in dump. No, this just seems to be internal stuff related to base64 and nothing to the input. Okay, keep stepping. Okay. I don't see anything interesting happening. Nothing appearing. So, and it looks like we reached the end of the function without anything interesting going on. Let's see where we return into. Another return, runtime do init. So this base64 was actually called from runtime do init. Okay, it looks like we lost some time. Let's try some input again and see if any of the other breakpoints get triggered. No. Getting nowhere is part of the learning process. Let's move on. Let's look into this base64 again. The quick filter. Let's search for base again. So we have new encoding, encoding with padding, encoding and code, encoding to stra. Oh, this is it maybe. Okay, this first thing is actually related to stack. So let's ignore that. This is init. Let's remove that breakpoint and continue. Now we get triggered on the stra. Let's see what's going on. Some nice constant. And what do we have? Let's single step now. See what happens. Runtime makes slice. This looks interesting. And coding and code. Slice by two string. We are making some progress now. I've got a good feeling about this. Let's just single step a little bit more. I've got a feeling we hit a jackpot because we can see / users. This tends to be part of a user profile. So quite useful. Let's look at this. The other strings surrounding it, of course, are totally useless again. Oh, no, no, we have a good job. Well, we didn't do a good job, but we will. Thank you. Let's look deeper into this. We have a main. Let's go into the main of Go. I am recording at a low resolution, so not everything is visible like it should. Since I don't use graphs, I have to use labels to give meaning to my code and branches. POI stands for point of interest, just so that you know. I also see a super secret pass here. What's this? Can this be a password? Let's look to some of the references to this super secret password. So it is a pointer. I'm a bit confused about this. The surrounding strings are also not giving much away again. And this main. Okay, here we do have the wrong. So, okay, I will give this also a label. Let's look up a little bit. So we have a string replace, we have a CMP. We are reading something, printing passwords, and then we have a comparison with the keyword. Okay, that's probably what we need. Let's put a breakpoint here and see what happens after this read string. Our application was still running. Let's try this super secret pass. Nothing. Oh, of course, our breakpoint got triggered. So let's look at this. Rex, where is Rex pointing to? It's pointing to our input, super secret pass. Okay, that's good. Single step. We replace the new lines from the input. And then we have this comparison to Rex. And Rex is 15 and we are comparing it against 40. So yeah, this is wrong, of course. Yeah, let's just single step. We of course reached the wrong branch. Very annoying. How dare you to be a super secret pass and be wrong? Annoying. But we can now at least rename this keyword to expected string length. Let's look at the cross references to this. So we have an assignment and a comparison. And the assignment, that's the more interesting one. We have a concat. A replace that seems to replace c/users. Let's set a breakpoint at this assignment and then we restart the application we are pentesting, cracking. We get triggered again in the base64 library of Go. We ignore that. So now we have this string length in SCX and Rex. Let's look at Rex. Okay, this seems to be my username. Let's expand this. Let's select this. This seems to be base64 anyways. How can we copy this? Hexrace, why is there no copy here? Do I really need to go all the way with my mouse to the edit? Or can I just press Ctrl+C? Who knows? Okay, I'm creating a full length string in Notepad now, so that I can copy paste this into the Crackme. In the meantime, I will close this command prompt since we don't really need it anymore. Of course, the Crackme was paused, so let's resume it. And a new breakpoint gets triggered. This is after the read string. I guess we can single step now and go to the expected string length. And now it looks like that we are reaching the good job used. Let's continue the execution. And we are seeing the good job. While the Crackme is patchable now, we still need to figure out where this base64 is coming from and where the username is coming from. That's why I restarted the application, because I want to figure out what this encode to string is containing. Which string is being base64'd? I don't understand this fully yet. I think I will just ignore it and move on. Let's look deeper into this generation of the expected string length. We slowly scroll up. So here we have the base64. We have a string which is converted to bytes. Okay, that makes sense. Let's set a breakpoint here and see what happens. So what is the input here? Okay, if we look at racks, and then we have also have the hex dump, which contains the user profile, get environment variable. Right. This seems very familiar. As a next step, we will use an online Base64 encoder to test this conversion from the user profile. No need to start typing here. I should actually copy paste this. And of course, I have to deal with the lack of a copy in the pop-up menu again. Okay, I paste it and I have to clean this up again. And then I click the encode button. Where is the result? Hello? This Base64 really matches the last part of the password. I'm losing my mind. No, let's close this. This notepad we can keep, it is the password with the Base64. I'm trying to put all the dots together now. We have the user profile. Then we have this Base64. And most importantly, there is also this one string. Where is it again? Let's see. Ah, here it is. So this is being removed from the user profile. I think it is being replaced with an empty string. So we can actually test this with the command prompt. And yeah, let's do that. I placed the crackme in my documents folder. So there we go. Let's view the current user profile. So this is actually a crackme about a Go application and not about teaching you how to use the command prompt of Windows. I will set the user profile to easy to crack. And we will use that online website to convert this easy to crack to a Base64. That's what we're doing now. We encode it. And then I prepend this password to the Base64 and we have the full password that goCrackme should accept. Let's test this. Good job. And yes, I think we actually did a good job. And there's one more thing that we can prove. The Base64 of an empty string is actually empty. What did we learn? We learned that Go is very readable with IDA, that there is a main, and that this crackme trusts environment variables and that it can be solved without patching. I don't really consider this crackme to be that difficult. It shouldn't be rated 2, it should be rated 1 probably. Very easy. Okay, that was it. Thank you if you stayed with me and I hope you learned something.